you are not doing this, y'all. Oh, yeah. We got number two in the nation, Khalid. Salute, Brady. In here, front. I'm getting beat up this morning.
How long y'all work on that? How long y'all work on that? How long y'all work on that?
That's been years. You want to run a tie, goddamn.
We're here. Gleason's Gym.
Oh, yeah.
Brooklyn, New York.
Oh, yeah.
Killa Cam.
Oh, yeah.
Shawn Cambry.
Oh, yeah.
About to get back to work.
Motherfucking right. This is what the fuck we do, bro. Let's go, man.
What is it we do, though, Cam? Listen, how's training man, looking? We about to get
working,
back to work
working,
on Friday.
I'm just pushing it right now. Oh, I just want to hurry up and get this fucking thing over with, bro. I'm not even going to lie to you. We've been going so hard. What do we have, like, what, 5, 6 days?
Six,
whatever the fuck. Something like that. I just want to hurry up and just get this shit over with, man. I've been sparring, been training, been doing, you name it. It's just time to fucking go to work. That's it. My mind is already, you know, it's already there. You know what I mean?
Now you see me get some good sparring working, Cam. Talk a little bit about some of the sparring you made.
I'm fighting a guy by the name of Aaron Drake. I don't really know too much about him. You know, I was looking him up trying to see who he fought or whatever. Can't really find too much. What I did find was, I think it's on YouTube where he fought the kid Upshur and he kept switching. He's a wild motherfucker. He coming and switching and whatever. So, because of that, really, I've just been training. I've been going all over trying to get like sparring with a lot of different people. Just so I'd be pretty much prepared for anything. I sparred Eddie Gomez, who I think he got a fight on the Pavitnikov Matisse undercard. You know what I'm saying? So he's fighting like the week after. I sparred him. I had some work with Patrick Day. I had Jonathan Cepeda. I had Akil. My man Akil come through. He came through. We did some work yesterday. I sparred my man Shawn. Strong guy, very hard hitter. Just different styles, you know, guys that box, guys that slug, whatever. I just try to basically just stay in shape and try to fucking see if I could get any style, anybody in there where I could just be able to adapt on site, on the spot, you know what I'm saying? So far it's going pretty good, but I'm just dying to hurry up and get this shit over with, you know? I ain't gonna lie to you.
No doubt. And coming up on this Friday, Cam, you got your man, your stablemate, Mikel Lespierre's on that card. Some other your gym mates are on that card too. Really kind of loaded up with a lot of the Brooklyn talent. Talk to me a little bit about fighting on this card and, you know, kind of that emotional ride you're going to take as well with your man Mick also fighting on the same card, with you both having that same kind of nervous energy.
What's insane is that I worry more about them than me. I mean, these guys are, you know, McNasty is ultra talented. This guy is one of the smartest fucking boxers, one of the best. Like, he's pretty good from a mental standpoint, from a boxing standpoint. Like, he knows his identity. So there's really nothing to worry about, but it's my miss. I want to make sure that he's doing the right thing. Ellie trains with us. She's also having her debut on that card. And of course, Patrick Day's on that card. And, you know, a couple other guys that are out there, like really a well-established. Wesley Ferrer, his name is, he's on there. Galarza, I think, is the headline. And the Ukrainian guys, them motherfuckers came through the fucking... It's gonna be a night, like one of them fucking bang out nights, man. My stablemates, though, I'm really more concerned about them. You know, all these other guys are talented or whatever, but I just want us to go in there and show out. We've been working hard and it's just really time to go out there and execute. I think we're gonna do a good job.
No doubt.
I honestly think so.
And not overlooking anything, Cam, but you know, assuming everything goes how it's supposed to go next Friday night, you know, how special is it for it, you know, afterwards that everybody chalks up them W's? Just, you know, how cool is it going to be to, you know, be amongst a group of everybody in victory?
That is what the fuck. I mean, listen, it's boxing, of course, anything can happen. But as of now, that's where my mind is. We're all gonna go in there and we're gonna show the fuck out. Period. You know what I'm saying? These guys work hard and I've been pushing my shit. Like, bro, you can see me. I don't even give a shit right now. I'm not even, and no haircuts, no nothing. We're just gonna go in there. Yeah. So, I don't know, like, it's to me personally, it's gonna mean a lot. Because I see what these guys do on a daily basis. I see these guys come in here and train, and we're all on the same team. It's one team, one fight, man. We all go in there together, fight together, win together. That's what the fuck we do. That's my mindset, you know what I'm saying? So, come next week, the goal, the plan is basically to go in there and show the fuck out. Period.
No doubt. And something else, Cam, since you hooked up with your new manager, and you know, with the contract with the Bella Entertainment,
right?
2015 is looking right. Looks like you're gonna be busy now, like how you've always wanted to be.
Right.
Talk to me a little bit about your excitement and knowing that you're gonna stay active and you don't have to concern yourself with all that as much as you used to have to.
I don't even want to go there because this is how it's supposed to be. You know, I mean, of course, nothing is perfect, but. Like, my last fight was a perfect example of how it's supposed to be. You show up at the weigh-in, you make weight, everything goes according to plan. The opponent shows the fuck up. You know what I mean? At this pace, or at this rate, after this fight, I want to get at least four more in. You know what I mean? God spares my life and I remain healthy and everything goes according to plan. I want to fight as much as possible because I don't do anything else. I really don't. Like, you know me, bro. I live here. I live in a fucking gym. It's like I work here. This fucking guy might as well hire me to fucking clean the bathroom or something. Cause I'm in here for hours at a time on a daily basis every fucking day. So, you know what I mean? After the fight, I probably take a week off. Cause I'm just so tired. I've never felt like this. Like, it just goes to show that I've really been pushing myself, you know? So, I'm probably gonna take a week off, which I never normally do. Like a week off after, just to recuperate, and then I'll be right back in here. Training, and hopefully, you know, we get some more, this is April 10th. Probably like the end of May, maybe middle of June or something like that, I wanna get back in there. I just wanna keep going, you know what I'm saying? Going there, but provided I don't get cut or any, you know, if everything goes according to plan, we would be as busy as possible. Period.
No doubt about it. And that next stop is next Friday night, the Aviator Complex, Brooklyn, New York.
Sir.
Y'all get at Cam for tickets.
Cam.
But
Disrespectful Cam on Instagram, disrespectfulcam.com, Killa_154, Shawn Cameron on Facebook. Just fucking get at me, son. Let's get these tickets moving. Let's go out there and start a fucking riot and have fun and watch me do some work. Period. This is what the fuck we do.
We out.
Yeah. Fuck out the way, man. Yeah, motherfucker. Get the fuck out the way. You see how I'm extra medium right now? Wait till I take the shirt off.
Jojo, come here.
Extra medium.
Extra medium.
Both of y'all.
No smedium?
Negatory.
Ooh. Yeah, hey, Mel. I see you, baby. Yeah, no, nigga. That ain't what the fuck I'm talking about. That ain't got nothing to do with what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about? Huh? You know what I'm talking about? Rip, why you limping, son? What the fuck is going on? Still? You got a stiff knee for like 5 years, nigga.
At least I'm consistent.
Yeah, don't run.
Don't run there. You're always on the other side. I noticed you've been on the other side of me all day long. This last couple of weeks. You right, Cat. Right. What?
Yo, this week coming, we're gonna pull together. We're gonna unite. We're gonna unite.
Yo, I'm training. Fuck up, man. Get on.
Get on with the get on.
Get on.